19 junior high and high school girls spent a week learning how to design, build, and program Lego robots. 2013 marked the second year for the Aquabots Summer Camp, put on by the University of Kentucky and the Kentucky Girls STEM Collaborative Project. The goal of Aquabots is to encourage girls to consider science and engineering careers. In addition to completing a series of challenges to create Lego robots to float on and below water, the girls get to work with female mentors who are studying engineering at UK and talk with women engineers who work for Lexmark and Lockheed Martin.
When I was in ninth grade, I took a robotics class using the Lego Mindstorm program in the NXTs. And that's actually what got me interested in engineering.
There's only like one or two girls in my classes. I am in computer science. And so it's good to go out there and teach these girls that it's okay to become an engineer and to show them like, I'm an engineer and you guys can do it too.
People aren't pushing girls to be engineers or doing anything in the STEM fields. And so if you get girls interested at a young age and if they develop a passion for it, then that's something that they're gonna wanna keep doing and they'll take it for the rest of their life.
I like it because it really puts me in a position that a lot of our young ladies in engineering are in. You know, I'm the only male, and I think I get to feel a little bit of the intimidation that our young ladies feel that go through engineering, who are historically underrepresented. So the concepts that we teach are mathematics through robotics. We also talk a little bit about programming, and that's an area where young ladies are definitely needed. And it's not just programming for programming's sake. There's an application involved, and you get immediate feedback. Does it work? Does it not work? Oh, you lost your propeller.
They get really frustrated whenever something goes wrong. You have to kind of make them sit down and go through the process of brainstorming and coming up with a new design in the program. But it's really cool to watch their faces light up whenever they finally get it right and they succeed in their mission.
That's perfect.
I learned like what kind of controllers to use and what kind of pieces to put on the robot to make it like go in the water, float, not float and tip and stuff.
The most challenging part was getting the boat to float properly, which did require a lot of trial and error.
So far I've learned about the buoyancy and about how even a boat must be and how to get it to be even, along with programming it so that it can drive around in the water.
Get the gear trains to work with it right and getting it all stabilized where it stays and works. I've done computer programming before, but I've not done it to make something move.
It's all the testing, designing the things and then realizing that it doesn't work and then redesigning it until you get a product that you like.
You have put forth many different ideas and you want to see if it has worked. Science is definitely one of my most interesting subjects to me. There's so much, you can never learn too much science.
The fun part is getting the challenge. You just want to be challenged, you don't want to give up, you just want to go forward and complete it.
There's just so much to learn, and no matter how much you learn, we're always learning more and more about the world and everything, so you can never stop learning. I think that's the most interesting part.
I want to be an engineer when I grow up, and I'm not really sure what kind I want to be yet. And so I'm trying to go to as many like camps or things as possible so that way I can like figure out if I want to be mechanical or electrical or even biomedical.
I love math and science and I think engineering, and I like to use robots. I like to be a teacher, but after coming to this camp, I feel more like being an engineer because they're kind of like saying engineering is awesome, and now I feel like engineering is awesome.